You're watching the Bermuda Channel.
Hi, I'm David LaHutta, and welcome to the city of Hamilton, the capital of Bermuda since 1815. Once a modest port town, Hamilton is now the hub of the island's economy, home to large financial institutions, investment banks, and insurance firms. It's also home to world-class seafood restaurants and shops, selling everything from diamond rings to Bermuda shorts. Come see for yourself as we spend the day exploring the city of Hamilton.
A.S. Cooper's was started by my great-grandfather, Alexander Samuel Cooper, in 1897. So we've been around well over 115 years. And it started out as a dry goods store. And over the period of time, it's evolved into Bermuda's largest emporium for fashion, cosmetics, fragrances, gifts, fine jewelry, you name it. We've got it.
On the ground floor of A.S. Cooper's flagship store on Front Street, you'll find all the most popular fragrances at duty-free prices, including Bare Minerals, La Mer, and Bobbi Brown. Or why not get a quick treatment or beauty consultation at La Serena Express Spa? If it's fine jewelry you're looking for, you must take a look at A.S. Cooper's original Bermuda collection. The first items were designed almost 50 years ago, and every piece in the collection is handcrafted in our store. The Bermuda longtail is one of the most popular, but there are lots of other Bermuda motifs, such as the hog shilling, flowers, tall ships, and dinghies. Another local favorite is Alexandra Mosher's Studio Jewelry. This popular collection features Bermuda's pink coral sand and high-quality silver sterling. Within the store, you'll also find the picturesque gallery featuring works by renowned local photographer Roland Skinner. There's everything from mini prints to full canvases to coffee table books, all featuring breathtaking images of Bermuda. A.S. Cooper's is the exclusive vendor for Wedgwood, Villeroy & Bock, and Port Marion tableware, including many items that are treasured by collectors. Coveted items from the range of Waterford Crystal and Swarovski are also sold here. And you'll find all china and crystal at prices up to 30% below U.S. retail. But there's so much more to explore on all three floors of A.S. Cooper's Front Street store, including two huge floors packed full of U.S. designer fashions. Loren, Michael Kors, DKNY, Vince Camuto, Calvin Klein, and many other top names are here, plus a fabulous selection of handbags. You can also shop for unique items of resort wear, reflecting our island lifestyle. From straw hats to flip-flops and everything in between. And the prices are very affordable. The store is completely wheelchair accessible, so it's easy to visit all of the fabulous fashion floors. For teens and junior fashions, Cooper's Express in the Washington Mall on Reed Street is the place to go. And A.S. Cooper's also has a special store just for kids on Front Street, opposite the ferry terminal. Right next door is A.S. Cooper's Men's, the largest and most popular men's fashion store in Bermuda. Polo Ralph Lauren is an exclusive, and this is the only place in the world that you'll find Brooks Brothers outside of their own stores. Tab's Bermuda shorts are a mainstay of most Bermudian men's wardrobe. Vineyard Vines, Lacoste, and Tommy Bahama are all top sellers, and all at the same prices you'll find in the U.S. If you're staying or traveling outside of Hamilton, A.S. Cooper's has two stores in the west end of the island, where you'll discover a selection of fine merchandise from the main store. They are located in luxurious Fairmont, Southampton, and in the Clock Tower Mall and Dockyard. For all the details on A.S. Cooper's, visit their website or follow them on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, Twitter, and Tumblr.
I'm a born Bermudian. My family's been here since the early 1700s. It's a beautiful place to live and work. And here at Ashwood Dickinson, we like to capture some of that beauty and offer that to our customers. So this flagship store was actually 111 years in the making. And we felt that it was important that we create a brand new, modern, first-class environment.
We're right outside the ferry terminal. So when the big ships dock in dockyard, they have little tenders. We're the first place you see. We're there for you. So part of the service is we don't have to wait to give you the best experience.
We have a very loyal clientele base. Many of them are here in Bermuda, but some of them are spread out all over the world.
We operate at world-class levels. So understand, some people just want to get in, have their questions answered, get out. Others want to take their time, relax, take it easy. Others want information. Some people just want to have fun with their shopping. So every person should get the experience that's right for them.
We've developed the original Bermuda collection, and that's something unique to Aswood Dickinson, unique to Bermuda.
It's called the original Bermuda collection because we're the first people that made it. All handmade by Julian and Diana in our own workshop. That's something that's remained with us, very popular to this day. Each year, we launch a new piece.
We started the first piece in 1974. On a 25-cent piece, there's a long tail, and we saw pierce the long tail out, and that was our first piece. In fact, the Bermuda collection is all 18 karat gold.
So 111 years in the making, this store will continue to thrive. We hope to be around for at least 111 more. I know you'll be impressed.
One of Bermuda's regular visitors is Queen Elizabeth. Her Majesty is said to have a particular fondness for the island, having made 5 official visits. Her most recent was in November 2009 to mark the 400th anniversary of Bermuda's colonization.
We're here with Peter Crisson, the president of Crisson, a family-owned jewelry store right here in Hamilton since 1922. So Peter, tell me a little bit about the history of your store.
Well, it was business was founded in 1922 by my grandfather and my great uncle, H.S. and J.E. Crisson, of course. And I think they saw the future in Bermuda, that being tourism at the time, and opportunities for growing a business. But I think most importantly, they really love the jewelry trade. Mm-hmm.
So we're here at your flagship Front Street location, but are there other shops across the island where folks could go?
Yeah, this is, you say, is our flagship shop, and all of our most significant product line selections are here and complete collections. But we have our original location on Queen Street still, which is a lovely classic shop. We have 2 shops in Fairmont Hotels, Fairmont Southampton, Fairmont Hamilton, and a shop in the clock tower in Dockyard.
Wonderful. So I know that your shop sells fine jewelry from a wide spectrum of brands and price points, but Crisson is also the exclusive distributor for Rolex watches here in Bermuda, is that right?
That's absolutely correct. We have been since 1970. It's basically our premier watch brand, something we're very, very proud to sell. Something we really go to great pains to have the full collection of, one of the best collections of Rolexes you're gonna see anywhere.
And you know, it's true that folks could really save some significant cash by buying here in Bermuda, is that correct?
Yeah, absolutely. We sell at Rolex's Swiss retail price, which is the lowest price anywhere in the world that a brand new Rolex can be purchased from an authorized agent. And over and above that, we sell with no VAT tax and no sales tax.
Sounds like a fantastic deal. So let's talk about some of the watches that are here in your case today. What if money was no object? What watch would you recommend?
I think I have one for you.
Okay. What do we have here? Well, this looks special.
This is the latest Gents Rolex president. 18 karat gold, and as you can see, a full bezel of brilliant cut diamonds and a baguettes and brilliant cuts on the dial as well.
So then tell me, what if I wanted an entry-level Rolex? If I'm new to the brand, what would you recommend?
Yeah. I think for you, a real sports model, I think the Milgauss, which is a classic, been around since the 1950s. Durable, you can wear it all the time.
Now that's a handsome watch. So these are great options for folks who might have a few extra dollars to spend, but what if I wanted to buy a gift that was maybe a little bit more casual?
Well, we have 37,000 different items in this shop. So I think there's something here, but allow me to mention something we put in 4 years ago. We're really very proud to be the exclusive agent in Bermuda for it, and that is Pandora. Jewelry for all of life's significant occasions.
Wonderful. Well, Peter, you have a beautiful store here. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you.
All right.
You're watching the Bermuda Channel.
The Robin Hood is the island's only authentic English pub, serving a great selection of draft beers, including Boddington's, Guinness, Foster's, Sam Adams, Stella, and Carlsberg, as well as more than 20 brands of bottled beer. Delicious pub fare is served at very reasonable prices, including traditional dishes, such as an English breakfast and fish and chips, as well as vegetarian options and Indian cuisine. Many rate the pizzas as the best on the island, and our curry second to none. The Robin Hood is also Bermuda's number one sports bar, with several giant plasma screens to capture the excitement of European football and other popular sports. Test your knowledge at the most popular quiz on the island every Tuesday night at 8 p.m. Live music, cold beer, sports and great food make a visit to the Robin Hood pub irresistible. The Robin Hood's location on the outskirts of Hamilton means that you probably won't stumble on it by accident. But it's only a short two-block stroll north from Front Street on Richmond Road, or ask your cab driver to take you to the hood.
So I've been all around town today, and wherever I go, everyone says to stop by the island shop for tan-painted pottery and island-inspired gifts. Let's go inside and check it out. Now this is what I'm looking for. Gosh, this is beautiful. Can you tell me a little bit about this?
Sure. Hi, I'm Barbara.
Hi.
Vincent. I'm the artist and the owner of the shop. And these are all ceramics that I've designed. They're all hand-painted pieces, and they all coordinate one with the other. I have many collections, but this was my first collection, the Cottage, Bermuda Cottage Collection.
So now these are all really just island-inspired pieces, is that right?
Yes, all my pieces are. For instance, this is Bermuda's architecture, and I've taken pieces of Bermuda's heritage, that the shutters, the heavy roofs, and I've incorporated them all into my ceramics. But I also feature wildlife, the lizards, frogs, butterflies that you'll find here.
Now, I was told everywhere I went today that you also have gorgeous linens and placemats and napkins. Do you have those things available as well?
Yes, I do. They're in the back of the shop, and they also reflect my ceramics and all the themes of Bermuda.
Wow, so all these pillows look fantastic. What do we have here?
Well, this is a pillow that ties in with my ceramic that you saw, the Bermuda Cottage. And I have a background in architecture, so the architecture here is of particular interest to me. And I have depicted it on a lot of my linens, and my pillows are just one part of the linen collection. But it depicts the cottage, the heavy chimney, the beautiful white roofs we have here to collect rainwater. The shuttered windows, these are all things that are typical of Bermuda's homes.
Now, I love the Bermuda cottages. Are there other designs that you have on pillows and linens?
Yes,
as well?
I have some beautiful wildlife, the parrotfish, which again is a beautiful fish that you'll find on the reefs, nibbling on the reefs here outside of Bermuda. And people love the colors of the parrotfish, so I've just incorporated into my pillows, but I also have placemats, napkins, tablecloths, and you'll find the parrotfish.
Barbara, your shop here in Hamilton is absolutely gorgeous. But if people are visiting other parts of Bermuda, are there other locations where they could buy your pottery?
Yes, there are. I have a shop in St. George's, and I also have a shop at the Southampton Princess, and I have some items down at Dockyard at the Art Center there.
Because our roads are so narrow, there's a strict subcompact limit on the size of cars in Bermuda, and only one car per household is allowed. Otherwise, the roads would become far too crowded. But what many visitors find even more unusual is our strict enforced speed limit of 21 miles per hour.
On most weekdays, the city of Hamilton swells to about 15,000 people, working residents of Bermuda that fill the capital streets. Fortunately for you, there's plenty to explore while the rest of the island punches in. The city is small and easy to navigate by foot, which means you could spend your day marveling at the hidden gems of Hamilton. Joining me is Tim Rogers, a local historian who's been giving tours of Bermuda and the city of Hamilton for more than a decade. Tim, tell us where we are right now.
Well, this is Par-la-Ville Park, David, and 100 years ago, this wasn't even in the city, hence the name Par-la-Ville. 200 years ago, a French family moved down to Bermuda via New York. They built the house that stands inside the park, now a historical museum. And to paint a picture, I mean, this would have been a cedar forest before Hamilton came about as a city. And then this guy, William Perrott, he turned it into a citrus orchard, and this was a commercial orchard. And so New Yorkers, Torontonians, everybody would be able to buy the famous Bermuda citrus. He was also postmaster of Bermuda. But the park definitely looks very different today. It's filled with all sorts of exotic plants, just fascinating plants to look at. It's like a mini botanical gardens, and lots of sculpture as well, which is really cool to see and cool to look at.
Wow, it seems like a wonderful place just to sit and eat your lunch, maybe write a postcard. Speaking of which, I've got one that I need to send back home. Is there a post office around that I could probably stick this in the box?
You're right in the perfect spot. It's just around the corner. I can take you right to it.
Shall we?
Okay. Well, here we are, David. This is the home of the famous Bermuda postage stamp issued in 1848, the Perrott Post Office. Let's
Fantastic.
Go inside.
Thanks a lot. So how old is that tree?
Well, that was planted as a 2-foot-tall sapling by William Bennett in 1848. Hard to figure that it's grown to that size now.
So this looks like an interesting statue. What are we looking at here?
Well, David, it's a part of recent Bermuda history. 50 years ago, it's hard to imagine, but black Bermudians were not allowed to go to the same movie theaters, bars, or hotels as whites or white Bermudians. There was a movie theater very close to here, and the sculpture represents people holding placards because they were boycotting the segregation of the movie theaters. And within a matter of months in 1959, blacks could go into the same movie theaters, restaurants, and bars. When Voices Rise is the statue title, and unveiled 2 years ago.
So this is a pretty impressive building.
It is, isn't it, David? You're pretty much in the center of the city. It is the City Hall, and its architecture is kind of interesting. A local guy by the name of Will Onions studied in Europe, and he really got the City Hall in Stockholm, Sweden, where they do the Nobel Prizes. And so he starred this building, which is just over 50 years old, on that.
So what can folks expect to see when they go inside?
Well, first of all, David, you've got two art galleries. The National Gallery of Art, which has a permanent collection of works done of Bermuda by visitors and locals.
Okay.
And then an ever-changing exhibit, which is kind of cool, gives some fresh freshness to it. And then you've got the Bermuda Society of Art. So these are local artists who are struggling to make their way in the art world. In the foyer of the City Hall, you've got pictures of the various mayors of Hamilton going back to its origins 2 centuries ago. You've got a portrait of the Queen, which is kind of fun to look at. And then at various times of years, the City Hall is also home to theater and music groups, concerts, and magic shows. George Summers Tucker, one of our early mayors of Hamilton, and his daughter in the 1930s provided nearly £40,000 of seed money to build this city hall. So she never got to see it actually happen, but since all of these portraits were done posthumously, the surviving family were given permission to have a portrait larger than life, whereas you notice everybody else, it's a head and shoulders only.
So these are all different mayors of Hamilton?
The right worshipful mayors, absolutely, yes, from the most the oldest through to the most recent. Well, this was done just over 20 years ago, David. Portrait, obviously, of Her Majesty the Queen. And she didn't actually do a sitting for this one. So it's done from photo images, photo archives, postcards. And I think it has to be said that the skin tones are a little bit odd. And there's a funny story that goes along with it, that when the Queen's come to Bermuda, they've actually taken the portrait down and tucked it away so that she doesn't see her somewhat jaundiced flesh. Well, incidentally, David, this is the public bus terminal, and buses leave from here to go to St. George at the East End and Dockyard at the West. It's a regular service and it's very affordable.
How much does it cost?
You're looking at $4 for a journey from one end of the island to the other, or you can buy day passes or week passes, making it even cheaper.
Oh, that's not bad at all.
Not bad at all.
So we've only walked a few steps from City Hall and we've come upon this magnificent structure behind us. Tell me about this church.
Well, we are on Church Street, David, which is easy to remember, and it's actually our Anglican cathedral. It's just over 100 years old, and yet its architecture looks very different from that. It's built of local limestone rock, but because they started on a French cathedral, the yellow stone around the windows, sandstone, is actually from France. One of the lesser known tourist attractions with the cathedral is to climb the tower. It's a lot of steps,
wow.
But you get some awesome views over the city.
So these columns, where are they from?
Well, they're from Scotland, David. It's called Peterhead Red Granite. And you see a lot of cathedrals and churches in the West Indies making use of them because they're strong, robust in a hurricane zone.
So all these wooden pews are gorgeous. They must be Bermuda cedar.
Actually, David, they're not. It's Indiana pine and no real significance except it was plentiful and it was cheap. The choir pews, however, they're made of English oak.
Really?
That would seem to be the right thing to do in an English colony like Bermuda. But we've had some Bermuda cedar incorporated into the cathedral. And if you look up into the roof space, it really does look like the upturned ship's keel.
It does.
So typical of early European cathedrals, and that is made out of Bermuda cedar.
Wow, it's unbelievable the amount of craftsmanship that has gone into this cathedral.
It really is, and when you consider it was constructed in 30 years compared to many cathedrals in Europe that took generations and generations of people to construct.
This looks like an interesting building. Is that Italian terracotta?
It is, David, absolutely. Yeah, the building is the Houses of Parliament, so it's where matters of state are decided for Bermuda. The building's older, but the facade with the terracotta was added on 130 years ago. And at that point, Queen Victoria had celebrated 50 years on the throne. And so they decided to embellish the building with the terracotta facade, something that her and her husband really liked. And upstairs is where our parliament meets. Mm. And so it's the power base of Bermuda, if you will.
Interesting, and now parliament gets together about once a week, is that right?
That's right, just on Fridays typically. And so visitors can go into the house and they can see parliament happening. They can sit down and watch and listen to the debates.
So in addition to catching the parliamentary action inside, folks could really get a stunning view of Hamilton Harbor right from this hill.
Absolutely. It's another good reason to come up to this spot to get that great panorama.
Now, I hear there's some significance to this clock tower up here.
Well, believe you me, David, if I need to check my watch, it's one of the more accurate clocks in the city and definitely worth keeping an eye on.
So if I wanted to catch the 2 o'clock bus and set my watch by something, that's the clock I should be looking at.
It's the one I'd use, David.
Fantastic.
Well, here we are, David, at the Cabinet Building. Cabinet Building is where our Senate meets, and so it's the upper house of Parliament. Inside the building, we've got the Senate Chamber, which is really cool. Visitors can go in and see that. And the Premier has her office inside of there
as
well.
That's the leader of Bermuda.
That's correct, just like a Prime Minister or a President. The building dates back to the 1830s, so it's certainly got some age to it. And well worth having a look inside.
So it looks like there's quite a few historical monuments and statues here in the lawn. Do they have any special significance?
Yes, they do. We have a cenotaph, and so that's our war memorial. It's an exact copy of the one in London. And then we have a statue of a lady being burnt at the stake.
Oh my goodness.
And you might imagine there's a story connected with that. I think we should go over and have a look.
So who was Sally Bassett, and what does this statue depict?
Well, Sally Bassett was a black slave, 1730, and living on an estate in Southampton. And what she'd learned is that the government of Bermuda was trying to free blacks. And so if your master died, you might end up being free. So she worked out that maybe she could kill off her master. And so she took some poison and she gave it to her master. She gave poison to her daughter and granddaughter on other estates. Unfortunately, her granddaughter couldn't watch the young children that she was in charge of get sick. And so she turned her grandmother in. And the people of Bermuda, the government, decided to take matters into their own hands to make an example of Sally, and much in the way of witchcraft, to burn her at the stake. And so that's what this statue represents. It was done by a black Bermudian artist, and it was unveiled in 2009. And another great reason to pop down to the Cabinet Building grounds.
So the city of Hamilton really must have changed a lot throughout the years.
Well, I guess it's kind of inevitable. It's 200 years old, and so that's absolutely true. It has changed a lot, but Front Street is where it all began. And in fact, the houses, buildings across the street here, haven't really changed that much in 200 years. They'd be used as warehousing for the storage of goods people would bring in from around the globe. And then the folks would live upstairs. And today it's home to some of the finest retail stores that Hamilton has to offer.
Tim, that was absolutely fantastic. Thanks so much for your time. It was truly a fascinating walk around Hamilton. Just have one last question. I've worked up quite a bit of an appetite. Do you have any recommendations for a great place to get a bite?
Well, I would recommend the beach, but the beach Front Street, that is, and it's just down the street on the corner of Front and Parliament.
Fantastic. I think I'm going to get a bite.
Enjoy.
Thanks.
For good food and good times with good friends, there's no better place than Bermuda Bistro at the beach. They have great pub grub such as their famous 6-ounce bistro burger, fish and chips, and healthy options too. The lunch and dinner menu is amazing with specials every day featuring the island's freshest seafood and produce, and food is served until midnight. Enjoy amazing views from the outside patio or a friendly dinner inside. The bar is open from 9 a.m. to 3 a.m. 7 days a week, serving exotic island cocktails, frothy European drafts, and all the top bottled beers. The entertainment is great too, with major sporting events shown on giant plasma screens. Bermuda Bistro at the beach, a great place to eat and drink. Bermuda has its own highly trained army called the Bermuda Regiment. It also has a brilliant military band, as you'll find out if you're fortunate enough to be here for the regular beat retreat ceremony. The world may not be a safer place because of them, but it certainly sounds better.
Bermuda has been an integral part of Bacardi's history for 50 years. The brand moved from Cuba to the Bahamas in 1960. And on June 18, 1965, Bacardi established offices in Bermuda. Bacardi subsequently established Bermuda as its world headquarters, and Bermuda became the hub for the rapid expansion of the Bacardi company that now operates in more than 100 countries. The early days in Bermuda were, however, very modest.
We had a small, a couple of desks and two offices, I think.
in the International Center, and that's where we started. It was me and a bookkeeper, and Carlos Bosch arrived, and Juan Prado, and Eduardo Catias.
So we moved from that little office that we were for, in, you know, in a room there, in the middle of nowhere, to move to another one because all of a sudden we were six. And then all of a sudden, you know, we kept on going. And then it was like in 1972, I think it was, that we went through the Bacardi Building.
Back in 1992, we brought the five separate Bacardi companies into one holding company here in Bermuda. And that was a massive change in the company. Shortly after completing that reorganization, like 3 months later, we started the acquisition of Martini and Rossi. The complexity of the company was quadrupled.
The number of employees increased quite naturally over time, and we eventually got up to close to 100 employees.
And then, you know, we went on, we did the acquisition. I was very involved with the acquisition of Dewar's Scotch and Bombay Gin. Grey Goose was a huge acquisition for us. The one connection over all the years is the family company. When I joined, this was a family company. The office felt like a family. This company is still a family company.
Family is absolutely, I tell you, I cannot describe it any more than loyalty family. Loyalty family was all about.
The family were just kind, thoughtful, gracious people.
Best place to work in Bermuda. The best.
Over the past 50 years, Bacardi has taken its responsibility to the community very seriously.
The philosophy of the company was such at that time that they came to Bermuda, established a presence here for the purpose of international marketing for Bacardi rum, but at the same time they recognized their responsibility in the community.
We have the wonderful opportunity to be partnered with Bacardi Limited in the title sponsorship of our biennial. And Bacardi has enabled us to run this Bermuda Biennial Contemporary Art Series for the last 22 years.
Well, we've had a great relationship with Bacardi, lasting since I've been here almost a decade now. And they've been a huge partner for the Bermuda Zoological Society.
For the past 11 years, pretty much since Knowledge Quest's inception, Bacardi has been a strong supporter of this charity.
Bacardi, as a very prominent business in Bermuda, has been a supporter of the National Trust for over 20 years.
Carter started a relationship with Bacardi in 2007, and they are making, from our perspective, a significant impact on the quality of life in Bermuda.
Bermuda End-to-End began in 1988. Bacardi have always had, you know, a major part in the event.
I ran a careers initiative for another organization and went to Bacardi and asked if they would get involved, and they stepped right up to the plate and supported an effort to help young people find successful careers.
It's wonderful to be able to celebrate more than 34 years of Bacardi giving to the Association of Bermuda International Companies Education Awards.
Bermudians now have access to modern medical care thanks to the support by many organizations, but in particular, Bacardi.
In many ways, Bacardi is truly one of the great corporate entities that is community engaged.
Bacardi's presence on the island has also influenced the growth of international business.
Bermuda's come a long way in terms of being an example of what can happen to a small island. And Bacardi has played a very major role in that process.
To say that Bacardi coming here led to lots of others would be no exaggeration. They put us on the map in more ways than one.
They became the template of how a corporation, international corporation here in Bermuda, should conduct themselves. They were the good corporate citizen.
We're so glad that in 1965, Bacardi chose Bermuda as its adopted home. And of course, we look forward to another 50 years of business growth and community participation between Bacardi and Bermuda. Happy birthday, Bacardi. Many, many happy returns.
Happy birthday, Bacardi Bermuda. And congratulations on a wonderful 50th birthday. And we hope for 50 years more and good health and good wishes along the way.
Congratulations to Bacardi for celebrating 50 years on the beautiful island of Bermuda. I want to thank the local community for always making us feel welcome, and thank you to the Bacardi employees in Bermuda for building such a great place to work.
These colorful masked dancers are called gumbes. The origins of the dance and costumes can be traced back to a mix of Afro-Caribbean and Native American influences. A troupe of gumbe dancers is generally made up of men from one family who pass on the dance and drum techniques from generation to generation. You can see the gumbes on Saturdays from 12:30 p.m. to 1 p.m. at Par-la-Ville Park in Hamilton.
This is Camden, the official home of Bermuda's Premier, which is located right here in the Botanical Gardens, a 35-acre park where you can have a picnic, take a walk, or literally smell the flowers. Just a few steps from Camden is the Masterworks Museum of Bermuda Art, a gallery which features a permanent collection of island-inspired artwork, plus seasonal exhibitions featuring local and international artists.
You're watching the Bermuda Channel.
Hundreds of people from around the world own homes right here in Bermuda, including billionaires, media moguls, and Hollywood celebrities. Some own homes for business, retirement, or just a vacation retreat. But how do you go about it? We spoke with the professionals at the property group who told us more.
Hi, I'm Sally Ann Smith from the property group. Bermuda is a wonderful place to live, as I have done for 30 years. Owning a home here can be extremely rewarding. Grand local homes range in price from around $3 million to upwards of $20 million, and they vary in character and location as widely as they do in price. Everything from secluded private estates to beachfront cottages to golf resort villas. A condominium is a great choice for those who prefer the convenience of turnkey living, with amenities such as tennis courts, swimming pools, and private beaches.
Hi, I'm Brittany Wyvell of the Property Group. Because the island of Bermuda is so small and space so limited, our government has had to introduce some restrictions to manage the availability of property to overseas buyers. At the Property Group, we're here to help advise you of those rules and would be pleased to show you a selection of properties available to overseas purchasers. Property here has proved to be a superior long-term investment. But really, it's the Bermudian lifestyle that motivates most buyers, and that is truly priceless. If you're interested in living in paradise, please call the experts at the Property Group today.
Just like America has its bald eagle, Bermuda also has a national bird, the longtail. Every year, regular as clockwork, they return from the winter bobbing around the choppy Sargasso Sea to nest in cliffs and have their young. And when Bermudians spot a longtail, they know summer is on its way.
Bermuda is known around the world for its turquoise waters and beautiful pink sand beaches. But which one's right for you? Join us as we count down Bermuda's top 10 beaches.
At number 10 is Dockyard Snorkel Park. They supply everything here for a perfect day at the beach. Number 9 is Tobacco Bay, a St. George's favorite and near the historic spot where the first settlers came ashore. Warwick Long Bay is at number 8. Long Bay is, surprise, surprise, the longest beach on the island, which makes it great for walking or running. Number 7 on our list is Shelley Bay, where the calm, shallow waters make it perfect for children and less confident swimmers. Six is Church Bay, a great snorkeling spot where you'll find ancient cannon just yards from the shore. Five is John Smith's Bay, loved by locals with super rich Tuckerstown as a backdrop. The most scenic small beach on the island is our pick for number 4, Jobson's Cove. At 3, Clearwater Beach, a little out of the way on the east end of the island, but well worth the trip. Albo Beach is at number 2. The posh private coral beach club is at one end, Albo Beach at the other, and in the middle, it's free and open to you.
Welcome to the number 1 beach in Bermuda, Horseshoe Bay Beach, right here in beautiful Southampton Parish. Not only is it the most spectacular beach on the island, but it's also one of the most photographed slices of pink sand anywhere in the world. And getting here is a breeze too. And spending the day here couldn't be easier. Just hop on the number 7 bus, and when you arrive, you can rent beach chairs, umbrellas, and even grab some lunch or a cool drink. With calm currents and warm breezes, the powdery pink sand of Horseshoe Bay Beach is perfect for anyone who wants to spend a day basking under the Bermuda sun.
The Yellowfin Group of Restaurants, 5 distinct restaurants, 1 mouth-watering standard. Amid the hustle and bustle of Front Street, Port au Call is the oasis of fine cuisine. The innovative award-winning contemporary menu features fresh local fish, homemade pastas, and the best locally grown produce. Add any of our extensive Wine Spectator award-winning wines to your dinner, including wines by the glass, and you're sure to have a meal to remember. Dine inside or al fresco on our terrace, enjoying the magnificent harbor view. And our early evening happy hours are legendary, a great way to mix with old friends or meet new ones.
For an intimate dining experience, let Porta Call host your next meeting, party, or family gathering in the luxurious surroundings of our private dining room. This room can also be set up for small meetings in theater or classroom style. Located above Porta Call Restaurant, Pearl is a welcomed addition to Bermuda's sushi scene. Skilled chefs use both their international culinary experience and their traditional Japanese training to create a menu with a unique flair. Food that will satisfy the classic sushi lover, as well as those looking for something a little different. Join us for an exciting sake cocktail before exploring our vibrant menu. Just around the corner, tucked away in the enchanting and historical Chancery Lane, Bistro J offers a wholesome and imaginative menu. The daily Blackboard specials include fresh local seafood, organic meats and chicken, and certified Angus beef. This casual culinary jewel is a must for those wishing to enjoy modestly priced fine dining in an informal atmosphere. Bistro J was recently voted Best Place for a Private Party in the prestigious Best of Bermuda Awards. Also on Chancery Lane, just a few steps from Bistro J and Front Street, is the newest addition to the Yellowfin group of restaurants, Ruby Murray's. Ruby Murray's opened in 2014 and has been wowing lovers of Indian food ever since. Here, you'll be served the finest Indian cuisine with creative flair, enthusiasm, and dedication. Authentic Indian spices and flavorful ingredients are married with prime local produce and cooked to perfection. Ruby Murray's is a runaway hit with diners and is the place to go for a real taste of India. 10 is Bermuda's most popular meeting place, coffee shop, wine bar, and the best choice for a light meal. 10 has a full range of delicious coffees, soups, fresh salad, sandwiches, and daily Blackboard specials. Complement your meal with a selection from the superb wine list. 10 has more than 40 wines available by the glass. 10, Pearl, Porta Call, Bistro J, and Ruby Murray's, five of Bermuda's most mouth-watering restaurants.
You're watching the Bermuda Channel. Which famous American said, "You die and go to heaven, I'd rather stay here in Bermuda"? It was Mark Twain, who was one of the first people to discover the delights of Bermuda as a resort.
We're headed to Bermuda's westernmost tip to explore the island's biggest attraction, Dockyard. It's home to the island's largest cruise ship pier, and it's also packed with tons of shops, restaurants, and exciting attractions. There's actually so much to see and do, you can spend your entire vacation here. But if you have just one day to spend, I'll show you some must-see highlights. So put on a pair of comfortable walking shoes and get ready to go exploring as we spend the day in Dockyard. Well, it's 9 a.m. and it looks like the shops are opening. Let's go check it out.
The commanding clock tower is a stunning arcade of shops in a unique setting. The most discerning shopper is sure to find something appealing while strolling along the stone-paved passages. If you're looking for island-inspired apparel or gifts, you'll find them here, as well as unique boutiques, art galleries, and tempting treats. Just next door is Making Waves for surf gear and the Dockyard Pharmacy for healthcare products. Close by is Island Outfitters, your one-stop shop for island adventure, or practically anything else you might need. Many artisans also call Dockyard home. Just along the road from the Clock Tower Mall are the studios of the Bermuda Clay Works, where you'll find outstanding artistic ceramics. Next door, skilled craftsmen at the Glassworks demonstrate their talent for creating functional glassware, as well as creative masterpieces. Bermuda's famous rum cakes are also made here by expert bakers. Once you taste a sample, you're sure to want to take some home with you. Or get on over to Bear Me Berry and choose from their tempting flavors of frozen yogurt and toppings. Delicious.
At
think it's time for coffee, and the pastry shop makes the best cappuccino on this side of the Atlantic. Even better, their pastries are baked fresh right here in their kitchen every day. No day-old donuts here.
Although the Royal Navy pulled out in the 1950s, this is still a working dockyard with a thriving yachting and boating community. You can learn all about the history of Dockyard at the historical reenactment performed at the Victualling Yard 3 mornings a week. Take the walking tour that immediately follows the reenactment and discover even more about this fascinating 200-year-old former naval base.
From here, you can go parasailing for an amazing bird's-eye view of Bermuda, go deep-sea fishing for marlin, tuna, or wahoo, charter a sailboat to explore the island, or my favorite, hop on a jet ski for some real speed on the water.
If you've ever dreamed of swimming with dolphins, your dream can come true right here at Dolphin Quest, located within the walls of the National Museum of Bermuda. Dolphin Quest offers encounters where you can swim, touch, and even kiss a dolphin, an unforgettably fun and inspiring experience.
When it's time for lunch, there are tons of restaurant choices right here in Dockyard, including this unique pub, the Frog and Onion. It's located in a 200-year-old naval cooperage, which is where they used to build and repair kegs, barrels, and casks. So in keeping with its naval history, there's a microbrewery right here on site. So in addition to some fantastic pub grub, you'll get a creative and certainly one of the biggest beers in Bermuda.
Many of the restaurants offer afternoon entertainment, such as local piano and guitar favorites. If you want to eat where the locals eat, choose the Freeport Seafood Restaurant. Their fish sandwiches are legendary among Bermudians. The Bonefish Bar and Grill has an award-winning chef and a fabulous patio with stunning views, while the family-style restaurant Cafe Amici serves delicious pasta and other Italian favorites. And for local fresh-caught fish dishes, try Woody's.
Well, it's time to walk off that lunch. And fortunately, you never know what type of history you might uncover as you walk through Bermuda's trails, parks, and peaceful green spaces. Now, this is one of my favorite places in all of Bermuda, just to sit and relax. And the best part is, it's just a few minutes outside of Dockyard's gates. Doesn't get much better than this. Beautiful view, a cool breeze in my face. There's no place I'd rather be.
Black Bay Beach is a little gem and far from the crowds. Snorkel, swim, or just relax in a hammock. Another option for a lazy afternoon is the Snorkel Park. You can lounge on a daybed, relax on the pink sand beach, or take a dip in the warm, calm water. But if you want to get more active, there's also snorkeling, paddle boats, kayaks, water slides, and beach volleyball.
By the way, you don't have to walk around Dockyard to see all these fantastic attractions. You can cruise around on your own two wheels by renting a Segway.
You can travel in a more traditional manner by renting a bicycle or ride in comfort aboard the trolley-style train. The train makes a continuous loop around all the major Dockyard attractions and is free to ride. So hop on and hop off at any of the stops.
You could even golf here in Dockyard by putting your way around the globe. Fun Golf is an oceanfront miniature golf course
that has recreated 18 of the world's most challenging holes, like this one, number 12 from Augusta National. Well, it's 4 o'clock, but there's still enough time in the day to enjoy a few cultural and historical attractions.
The British Royal Navy established the Royal Naval Dockyard after defeat in the American War of Independence. Its purpose was to create a massive fortification and stronghold for the Royal Navy to ensure British dominance of the Western Atlantic. You can learn all about Dockyard and 500 years of local history right here at the Bermuda National Museum.
Another thing that I love, you can check your Facebook page, tweet your friends on Twitter, or send a plain old email, since all of Dockyard is a Wi-Fi hotspot. Just grab your mobile device, search for an available network, and log on. The rates are reasonable, and it's as easy as pushing a button.
The wonderful old rooms of the Cooperage make an appropriate setting for the craft market. On sale is a fascinating selection of locally made products, such as cedar items, handcrafted jewelry, painted clothes, books, prints, and delicious Bermuda-made condiments. Many of the products are made right in front of your eyes. You can also sample locally produced fare. Nearby is the Art Center, where you'll see works by the island's most accomplished artists. Some pieces are available for sale. And if the kids want to run around while you browse, there's a wonderful playground right opposite.
And when the sun goes down, Dockyard keeps on going.
The very latest blockbuster movies play here at the Neptune Cinema. The pubs and bars come to life, the dining is outstanding, and amazing island entertainment and parties can be found throughout Dockyard.
My day in Dockyard's been a blast, and yet there's so much more to do. You know what? I think I'll be back tomorrow.
Find out more about the Royal Naval Dockyard, visit our website, or pick up a brochure at the Visitor Information Center or Clock Tower Mall.
Anywhere near Bermuda's South Shore beaches, you've got to check out Gibbs Hill Lighthouse. Erected in 1846, it's the second cast iron lighthouse ever built. You'll have a fantastic view of the island from this great outdoor platform, but for a 180-degree panorama of the entire country, all you've got to do is climb 185 steps to the top. Well, we've made it 185 steps to the top, and I've got to tell you, this view is unbelievable. Looking south, I could see the unending views of the Atlantic Ocean, tons of coral reef, and beautiful South Shore beaches. That pink building is the Fairmont Southampton. Then looking over this way, we could see Riddles Bay Golf Course, and the city of Hamilton in the far distance. Now, on the very west end of Bermuda is the Royal Naval Dockyard, which is another great place to visit when you're in town. But when you're here in Southampton, you'll definitely want to stop by Gibbs Hill Lighthouse. I'll tell you, this view is well worth the climb.
The architecture of Bermuda is instantly recognizable. Every building conforms to a strict code, and the walls are painted in pastels reflected of the natural coral, flora, and surf. But perhaps the most distinctive and appealing aspect of Bermuda homes are the amazing whitewashed roofs. Because the island has no fresh water, the stone roofs are designed to catch rainwater that is then stored in tanks built below the house.
There is only one chef in Bermuda who has won the highest and most prestigious award for chefs in France. In 1997, Jean-Claude Garcia was awarded the Leading Craftsman of France gold medal by President Jacques Chirac. Following this, his great ambition was to open the finest French restaurant on the island. And after searching for many years, he found the perfect location right here.
Welcome to my restaurant, Bon Rivage. We start with only the finest, freshest ingredients. Each day, we handpick only the best fresh fish and, in season, Bermuda lobster. Caught right here in our local waters by the island most experienced fishermen. And we personally choose the most colorful, luxurious vegetables and fruit from Bermuda's farmers market. Each day, we make our own delicious pasta, soups, and the many other items on the diverse menu. What is impossible for us to prepare in our own kitchen, we receive it from the island top supplier. Everyone is welcome in my kitchen. There are no secrets here. You can even book our one-of-a-kind chef's table and watch the chefs preparing your meal right in front of your eyes. There is also a choice of indoor or al fresco dining. But it doesn't matter. Wherever you sit at Bon Rivage, all the views are breathtaking. Come and visit us at Bon Rivage and let me prepare a meal just for you.
Bon Rivage is located at the Newstead Resort on Harbor Road and is open for lunch and dinner 7 days a week with a sensational brunch every Sunday. Reservations are advised.
You're watching the Bermuda Channel. Bermuda's national sport is cricket, a game with complex rules that can take a long time to play. But it's so popular here, for 2 days every summer, the island closes down for a cricket match and a party you will love.
Another great place to spend the day in Bermuda is Snorkel Park at the Royal Naval Dockyard. You could rent a kayak, paddle boat, snorkel gear, or just chill out on the beach where you could relax on the daybed or play a game of volleyball. Really, it's fun for the whole family and a great way to have a Bermudaful day. I think I'm gonna go explore. So I found a couple lovebirds on the beach. John and Carissa, how are you guys enjoying Snorkel Park?
We love it.
Fantastic.
It's been awesome. We've been out snorkeling today. We took a paddle boat ride.
Tomorrow we're going to hit the jet skis.
Oh, nice. That paddle boat ride sounds romantic.
Oh, it's so great.
Good. We just got married, so it's kind of a good, you know, marriage.
It's a honeymoon ride.
Honeymoon
Fantastic.
Type of thing.
You guys going to stick around tonight?
Yes.
We are. The island beach party's tonight. So we hear it's the best party on the island.
Sweet. So I hope to see you on the limbo floor.
Oh, that'll be my job.
Cool. What do you say we dig into some of this food?
Love to.
In addition to refreshing drink specials and mouth-watering food served on the beach all day, there's a fabulous beach barbecue in the evenings featuring scrumptious island cuisine. And after dinner, things really heat up at the island beach party.
I told you Snorkel Park is awesome. From kayaking to volleyball to some fantastic food right on the beach, it's the perfect place just to lay back and have a great time. Speaking of which, I think it's officially time for a Bermuda rum swizzle. What do you say, Mr. Monkey? I think he likes it here too.
Bermuda is one of the world's most sought-after cruise ship destinations. The island hosts 180 cruise ships that bring more than 350,000 visitors each year. Many of these ships make regular weekly runs from New York or Boston, but there are still a few that stop here on their passage around the world, like the grand liners of the past. You're watching the Bermuda Channel.
Sound crazy what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here, better take a break. Hot air balloon, I can go to space with the air like I don't care, baby, by the way. Because I'm happy kept alone. If you feel like a room without a roof, because I'm happy kept alone.
Bonefish is the happiest restaurant in Dockyard. No wonder it is consistently rated among Bermuda's top dining and entertainment venues. Nearby is their sister restaurant, Cafe Amici, on the corner of the Clock Tower Shopping Mall. Many guests come for the authentic Italian pizza, but Cafe Amici also serves traditional ravioli, risottos, and other pastas and salads. Or come on a Sunday morning for Bermudian codfish breakfast, complete with Johnny Bread. Best of all is dinner at Cafe Amici, where the menu also features steaks and fish prepared by exceptional European chefs. Bella Vista, located at the famous Port Royal Golf Club in Southampton, is part of the same group of outstanding restaurants. But you don't have to be a member or even play golf to savor this unique dining experience. Lunch and dinner are served daily, and every item on the menu is created using only the highest quality ingredients. Eat inside or out and enjoy the fabulous views from the patio. Bella Vista also has a private dining room available for small, intimate events. Bonefish, Cafe Amici, and Bella Vista are all owned by award-winning chef Livio Farrago. Many of Chef Livio's recipes are inspired from ones that his mother used when he was growing up in Italy. Livio now shares the recipes for these superb dishes in his cookbook, Amore Bermuda, The Passion for Italian Cooking, available from his restaurants or ask for it at bookshops around the island.
In the 19th century, Bermuda was often referred to as the onion patch. And indeed, the Bermuda onion was one of our most famous and profitable exports. Although Bermuda no longer exports agricultural produce, a wide variety of fruits and vegetables are grown here for local consumption, including strawberries, avocado, and bananas, cabbage, carrots, and potatoes. We're now in the depths of Crystal Caves, a natural wonder that you'll never forget. Every step across the large underground lake opens up to another beautiful vista. Breathtaking, isn't it? Your tour guide will point out the many rare formations and explain all about them. You can also visit Fantasy Cave, another exquisitely illuminated underground wonder, just a short stroll away. Fantasy Cave is a virtual jewel box filled from top to bottom with delicate formations. The deep pools of water hint at the underlying network of passageways connecting the caves with the ocean. The gift shop at Crystal Caves offers a fascinating array of souvenirs, and you can also relax over a coffee, cool drink, or a delicious snack under the shaded tables of Cafe Olé. Make sure you visit Crystal Cave and Fantasy Cave during your stay here. You won't be disappointed.
The beauty of the island is the inspiration for the evocative perfumes created here at the Bermuda Perfumery. We asked perfumer Isabel Ramsey Breckstone to tell us about the artistic direction behind this international renowned range of rare perfumes.
I compare fragrances with music. It speaks to your soul and it connects with you right away. You like it or not, and if you like it, it gives you great emotions of happiness and it can even energize you. Like music composers work with notes, we work with smells, which we also call notes. A single note would be, for instance, the one of a rose. To create a floral accord, I would take notes of rose, jasmine, and orange flower, for instance. And then when I create a perfume, I take accords from different scents like citruses, floral, woods, and I put them together to create a beautiful symphony for your nose. So each fragrance typically will contain between 50 to 100 different oils that we put together. There are a lot of people who come to the perfumery and they think we farm flowers and that we extract oil from plants, but we don't. These oils are extracted and made by specialized companies from all around the world, and we source our oils from them. So I work exactly like the French perfumers and the English perfumers. What differentiates my perfumes from them is the story I tell in my perfumes, and the story of my perfume is the story of Bermuda.
If you would like to learn more about the art of perfumery and even create your own fragrance, intimate studio workshops are available with our master perfumer. The Bermuda Perfumery is in historic Stuart Hall on Queen Street in St. George's, an exceptionally handsome residence built for a wealthy 18th century ship owner. This property is a fine example of authentic Bermuda architecture. You're invited to walk around and enjoy this exceptional property. If you are here on a Wednesday or Saturday afternoon, why not stay for afternoon high tea, served in our garden by Sweet Pea? The Bermuda Perfumery was recently recognized by CBS News and Travel editor Peter Greenberg on CBS This Morning as the best place in the world for perfume, and has also been featured on The View. Lily Bermuda fragrances are available at our flagship location on Front Street in Hamilton. And at the finest stores island-wide. And when you return home, you will find our products online at lilybermuda.com.
The entire archipelago of Bermuda would be the tiniest national park back in your country. But here, our 70 national parks are as minuscule as an acre, or even less. Don't let that fool you though. They are packed with interest, and even a short stroll will usually reveal a lot. A perfect example is Ferry Point Park in St. George's. It's a readily accessible mix of birders' paradise with historical mystery, with archaeological puzzle, with dramatic seascape, and even quiet forest glades. Also in the East End, located next to Clearwater Beach, is Cooper's Island Nature Reserve. Formerly the site of a NASA Space Agency tracking center, Cooper's Island has been brilliantly transformed and is now one of the largest publicly owned tracts of land in Bermuda. The jewel among the island's parks is the Botanical Gardens, which hosts more than 100,000 visitors each year. You really must see the formal gardens, featuring a Japanese Zen garden, 17th century style English parterre garden, 12th century style Persian garden, and Tudor style children's maize garden, each separated by a central viewing gazebo. The shallow water at Shelley Bay makes this the number one beach to take children. The nearby playground was recently voted best playground in Bermuda. But there are also many other fun-filled playgrounds across the island, such as this one in Warwick. Just below Warwick Playground is South Shore Park, linking the stunningly beautiful Horseshoe, Chaplin, and Warwick Long Bays with the dreamy dunes behind them. You could walk for hours barefoot in the soft sand trails, but you won't, because the water is too tempting to resist. One of the best ways to explore Bermuda is by taking a walk along the railway trail. The trail runs almost the entire length of the island, and a stroll along the secluded and leafy paths will reveal some unique views. Bermuda's railway trail and national parks are clearly marked. So, when you see these signs, stop and explore. You'll be glad you did.
You're watching the Bermuda Channel.
Thank you.
Founded in 1612 after an English ship crashed upon Bermuda's shores, St. George is a UNESCO World Heritage Site and the most historic part of the island. Joining us today is E. Michael Jones, former mayor of St. George, who will be showing us around town today. Michael, thanks for joining us.
It's a pleasure. Thanks for having me, Dave.
The one thing that I think is really amazing is that, you know, without St. George and without Bermuda, America as we know it probably wouldn't exist.
Well, that's very true. Because of the shipwreck that Sir George was involved in 1609, because of a hurricane, they took 10 months to build the two boats, sailed off to Jamestown, and rescued the starving colony. There was only 50 to 60 of the original colonists still alive. So they were able to take the food that they brought from Bermuda to stop those folks from leaving to go back to England. Indeed, America, indeed the world, may be a very different place if it wouldn't have been for that occurrence.
Excellent. Well, what do you say we take a walk?
Yeah, let's go. Come on.
All right.
Okay, the town hall was first used in 1797. St. George's was the original capital, and when the capital moved to Hamilton, the mayor then decided that this was the place that he would conduct his business. And it's still used by the mayor and the aldermen today to run the town's affairs. You can see the former portraits of all the mayors on the back. It's filled with Bermuda cedar and certainly has full world, old world charm.
You could really smell the history here,
oh,
too.
Absolutely.
So what street are we on now?
This is King Street, one of the most historic areas in St. George's. Here we have Bridge House, the former home of at least two governors. All three of these buildings, including the Buckingham and Reeve Court, are owned by the Bermuda National Trust. Hmm. And of course, at the top of the hill, we have our gem, the original State House when St. George's was the capital.
And when was that built?
Well, it was actually built in 1620. So, I mean, when you think about it, the Mayflower arrived in America in 1620. That building was just about standing. It was just about complete at that time, still standing and still in use.
Unbelievable. And I hear Bermuda got quite a deal on the rent on that
well,
place.
Well, actually, you know, the Freemasons of Lodge 200 of Scotland now rent it. It's one peppercorn per year. And it's never changed since 1815.
Holy moly, now that's a bargain.
Well, you talk about being stuck in time, boy, I'll tell you.
What kind of tree is this?
Actually, this is a Bermuda cherry tree. Look, there's a cherry there. Just pick it, put the whole thing in your mouth and spit the seed out. They're delicious.
Mmm, oh my gosh. It's sweet and it's tart.
Yeah. And every tree is different, and there's also no season for cherries. You can go by today, and maybe in November they'll have more cherries. It's not just one season, so you can get a second picking.
Thanks for the snack.
Oh, anytime, and we'll see these all along the way as we're going.
Awesome. So you've been telling me all about these whimsically named streets here in St. George, and we're here on Featherbed Alley. What's the story behind the street?
Well, actually, Featherbed Alley is very, very humorous. This building was built in 1730, but in the 1800s, there was a couple who lived here, and the husband was a bit of a drinker. The wife got sick and tired of him, threw him out to the bedroom window with the mattress and said, "You want to get drunk? You can sleep in the street." So he did. Next night, brought him one of his drunken friends. Both of them slept in the street. Of course, by then, all her neighbors and friends are gossiping about her husband sleeping in the street. So she said, "Get back in the house, get that scoundrel out of here." And that's the story on Featherbed Alley.
So we're on the steps of St. Peter's Church, which is truly one of the historical gems of St. George.
Oh, absolutely. St. Peter's has been in continuous use at this spot since 1612. As a matter of fact, when the invigilator came here to look at our designation as a World Heritage Site, he said this could be a World Heritage Site all on its own, leaving out the rest of the entire town.
Wow, and the church has a pretty amazing history as well. It's fairly old, is that right?
Oh, absolutely, and inside there's lots of historic things. We've got a baptismal font that's more than 900 years old. The oldest piece of furniture in Bermuda, probably since the first week that the church was started. There's also chandeliers from the 1800s. There's lots of fascinating things inside the church.
And it's the oldest Anglican house of worship in the world.
Outside of the UK.
Wow, well, let's go inside and check it out.
Sure, come on, let's go.
One of the most photographed sites in St. George's are the stocks and pillory, used to punish and humiliate those who broke the 17th century laws. During the American Civil War, the Confederate agent, Major Norm Walker, used these rooms to coordinate the flow of guns, ammunition, and other war supplies through the Union blockade. The island's involvement in the Civil War is explained in this fascinating exhibit at the Bermuda National Trust Museum in one of the oldest stone buildings in Bermuda, previously known as the Globe Hotel. Bermudians know this as the Unfinished Church. Started more than 130 years ago, it was intended to replace St. Peter's Church. But parish infighting caused the magnificent Victorian Gothic structure to be abandoned before its completion. You can get a glimpse of how Bermudians lived 250 years ago by visiting the Tucker House Museum, an old family home that showcases a magnificent collection of family silver, china and crystal, antique English mahogany and Bermuda cedar furniture, portraits, exquisite hand-sewn quilts, and many other treasures. Fort St. Catherine is Bermuda's biggest fort, and there's lots of really interesting things to see here, like replicas of Britain's crown jewels and a captivating diorama of Bermuda's history. This site is also the equivalent to America's Plymouth Rock, because it was here, back in 1609, that the Sea Venture, which was on its way to Jamestown, Virginia, carrying settlers, was shipwrecked. Miraculously, all 150 people on board survived and came ashore. And that's the story of how Bermuda came to be colonized by the British more than 400 years ago. And this is a replica of the Deliverance, built by those same early settlers to carry them on to their original destination of Jamestown. It's only 150 feet long, but was designed to carry 130 passengers, crew, and provisions across the Atlantic.
So I've really had a fantastic time walking these quaint alleyways and historic roads. I got to tell you, St. George to me is just a fantastic place to spend the day. So thanks so much for showing me around town.
It's our pleasure to have you. It really is a quaint, quiet town where you can stroll around. Everybody knows everybody. You can stop and pick some fruit and have some leaves and do some things and really just have a great time. It's a wonderful historic town and we'd love to have you come back anytime you want.
Thanks, Michael.
My pleasure.
One of Bermuda's favorite local hangouts is here in Vallis Village. You'll feel like family at Rustico. The friendly atmosphere and exceptional service makes Rustico a firm favorite with both locals and visitors. You'll want to savor every bite of Rustico's freshly made pastas, pizzas, and other traditional Italian favorites. The restaurant with the best views in all of Bermuda has to be the dining room, located at the foot of Gibbs Hill Lighthouse. Contemporary cuisine from around the world is served with an extensive wine list to match. If you're visiting Bermuda, try not to miss the dining room. Gulfstream is the newest addition to Bermuda's dining scene. Located opposite picturesque Horseshoe Bay on the South Shore, Gulfstream offers a variety of contemporary cuisine in a relaxed setting. Fresh seafood, local fish, and lobster are on the menu here. For meat lovers, ribeye steak and lamb cutlets are just two of the many choices, plus casual fare such as burgers, panini, and pizza. There's something to please every palate at Gulfstream. Rustico, the dining room, Gulfstream, three unforgettable dining experiences.
Bum, ba, da, ba, ba.
You're watching the Bermuda Channel. Bermuda has more places of worship per square mile than anywhere else in the world. In fact, we have more than 100 churches with almost every denomination represented here.
You haven't seen the real Bermuda until you've taken our fabulous cruise to the spectacular Sea Gardens and Wreck aboard the Reef Explorer glass bottom boat. You'll see wrecks of ships that have misjudged our beautiful yet cruelly unforgiving coral reefs and the spectacular fish that make their home in them. And because the Reef Explorer is Bermuda's largest glass bottom boat, you'll get the very best views of this undersea wonderland. Watch the water boil in a frenzy of fish as we feed them from the boat. And it's amazing what you'll learn from our friendly Bermudian crew as they entertain you with fascinating facts about Bermuda and the sea. On the way back, we stop off at a shallow reef teeming with colorful tropical fish for some fun snorkeling and kayaking. The Reef Explorer also has an evening pirate adventure cruise. Don't forget to hang on to your treasure as spirited pirates attempt to board our vessel. Later, we'll illuminate the glass bottom so you'll discover all the fascinating nocturnal sea creatures that come out to play at night. The Reef Explorer cruises depart from both Front Street, Hamilton, next to the ferry terminal, and from Dockyard, in the west end of the island. Be sure to remember the name of the boat, the Reef Explorer. Reservations aren't required, but to avoid disappointment, bookings may be made through your hotel concierge or visit us online at www.bermudareefexplorer.com or telephone 535-7333.
Has one of the greatest public transportation systems anywhere in the world, but it's not just for getting from point A to point B. It's also a fantastic way to explore the island. Let's hop on a bus.
We at the Department of Public Transportation look forward to taking you on some of the most beautiful bus routes in the world. We can take you anywhere from the Maritime Museum in the west to the town of St. George's in the east. For details on the bus schedules, just pick up any local telephone directory or ask your front desk receptionist at your hotel. Welcome to the island of Bermuda.
Please remember to have the exact fare in coins, as the drivers cannot accept dollar bills. For your convenience, there are tickets, tokens, 3 and 7 day passes available. These transportation passes give you unlimited travel on the ferries as well as the buses. Check with your hotel on the nearest outlet for these passes. For the comfort of other passengers, no wet swimsuits or sandy clothes on the buses, please. The bus is easy to get. They stop right at your hotel and at these pink or blue posts. And there's a quick orientation tip for you. A bus stop painted pink means it's going into Hamilton. And if you would like to catch a bus from Hamilton, come to the new terminus from which all buses leave the city. It's located 2 blocks north from Front Street, next to the landmark City Hall. From here, you can catch a bus to take you virtually anywhere on the island.
It was Miss Mary Outerbridge who first introduced tennis to the United States when she took a net, ball, and rackets to New York in 1874 to show her American friends this new sport.
For more than 400 years, the Cuban cigar has been considered the most superior cigar in the world. Is it because of Cuba's decadently rich soil? Or the country's unique climate? Or is it simply Thanks to the country's hundreds of years of experience growing tobacco and the skill of the torcedores, that makes each Cuban cigar a work of art and a delight to smoke. Discover the allure of the Cuban cigar for yourself. 40 Bucaneros purchase the very finest Habanos under license from the Cuban authorities and make them available right here in Bermuda. Cuban cigars are not only legal on our island, they're available by the box directly from 40 Bucaneros or most fine restaurants and shops in Bermuda. 40 Bucaneros has all the best Cuban brands available, including some special, aged, rare, and vintage cigars. Visit us online or in person. Plus, 40 Bucaneros will ship your cigars anywhere in the world. Discover the allure of the Cuban cigar. Discover 40 Bucaneros.
Come and discover Old English charm and hospitality at one of Bermuda's premier restaurants. For more than 40 years, Henry VIII has been serving the most succulent certified Angus beef, the freshest local fish, traditional pub favorites, and Bermuda's best fish chowder. And if you enjoy sushi, our chefs will create something very special for you. All prepared with the highest quality ingredients and served with a smile. Fine wine and traditional ales are served in the cozy comfort of our pub. Sunday brunch at Henry's is a local tradition and offers the widest selection of fine dishes at the most competitive price on the island. During the summer months, join us on our patio for live entertainment, breathtaking South Shore views, and the tasting barbecue menu served every Thursday night. And don't miss our legendary nights at Henry's, where the high-energy entertainment will have you on the dance floor all night. You won't want to leave the party. Henry VIII's also has private dining rooms available for all types of functions. Henry's Pantry stocks everything from wines, liquor, and beer to cold drinks and snacks. If you're visiting Bermuda, pick up something to take back to your room. The pantry is open 6 days a week, 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. For reservations, call 238-1977 or visit henrys.bm.
Did you know that Bermuda has one of the oldest post offices in the world? Dating back to 1812, the postmaster was William Perot, who was also one of the first in the world to issue postage stamps. The famous Perot stamps are reputed to be worth upwards of $250,000 each. Thankfully, for the thousands of avid collectors around the world, today the Bermuda Post Office issues 4 new series of stamps each year that are available at more reasonable prices.
Normally we produce around 4 issues a year, simply because at the end of the day, we don't have that postal need, because that's one of the things that drives how much we produce. So with our 4 issues, they usually carry about between 4 to 6 stamps per issue. That in itself keeps our stamp program small, and collectors like that because we don't produce too many stamps. So with the Bermuda stamps, I like to ensure that at least 1 issue out of the year will carry something with a significant Bermuda scenery. We have Bermuda history, look at architecture, sometimes we look at flowers, and if we get around to animals of sort and flora, fauna, things of that nature, we like to include. So it's always had to be something, of course, relevant to the island. Again, something advertising Bermuda, because our stamps, I consider them one of the biggest advertisers. They get to places where people do not necessarily reach. And even people overseas get to at least get a glimpse of the island by looking at our stamps.
To view the latest Bermuda stamps or to discuss having first day covers mailed to you, please visit the Bermuda Philatelic Bureau, located within the main post office on Church Street. Call 297-7508 or email
philatelic at gov.bm.
Welcome to the Bermuda Aquarium, Museum and Zoo, a great place to visit for people of all ages. Our mission is to inspire appreciation and care of island environments. We accomplish this through education, conservation, animal care, and family fun.
In the aquarium, we have 26 tanks displaying a vast array of fascinating local aquatic species. The North Rock exhibit, to my right here, a 140,000-gallon tank, displays a living coral reef along with the marine inhabitants which surround it. Some of the more popular species are the grouper, the barracuda, and even the moray eel.
The museum is a bright, spacious gallery filled with beautiful photographs, interesting artifacts, and interactive displays telling the story of Bermuda's natural history. Using a mix of traditional and contemporary exhibits, the museum focuses on the island's geology, biodiversity, and terrestrial and marine habitats. Visitors can easily appreciate our fragile island environment and learn about ongoing conservation research projects.
This is Sally, a Galapagos tortoise, one of more than 70 species of mammals, birds, and reptiles on display in the zoo. Our exhibits represent collections of diverse island environments from around the world. Visitors can meet the animals of the Caribbean and Australasia, or stroll through our latest exhibit showcasing the amazing creatures of Madagascar. So don't miss out on this extraordinary experience in our zoo. We have something for everyone, and we look forward to welcoming you.
If you're looking to be independent on your travels around the island and want to set your own schedule, rent a scooter. They are great fun and can take you everywhere in Bermuda's amazing network of highways and byways. Exploring on a scooter is safe and easy if you follow the rules. And there is an exhilarating sense of freedom in being able to go where you want, when you want. If you haven't ridden a two-wheeler recently, here are some tips on safe driving in Bermuda. Rule number one is, we ride on the left. You really have to remember this all the time because it's very easy to slip back into what you're used to. You have to be particularly careful at road junctions. When you approach a traffic circle, or roundabout as we call them here, you must give way to traffic on your right. When you are on the roundabout, keep going because you have the right of way. However, it's sensible to be cautious and ready to anticipate other drivers' mistakes. Now here's an accident just waiting to happen. The rider is looking behind to check whether his wife is still following him. He's beginning to wobble dangerously, but very wisely, he decides to pull over to the side of the road. If you're riding in a pair or a group, always put the slower rider in front. We have a 20 mile an hour or 35 kilometer an hour speed limit here, which is strictly enforced. Be warned, your bike can go much faster, so keep an eye out on the speedometer and be mindful of your speed at all times. Now this is vital. Always make sure your helmet fits snugly and is properly fastened. It's not only safe, it's the law. We have a breathalyzer system in operation on the island, so please don't drink and drive. To rent a scooter, all you need to do is call 236-BIKE. Oleander Cycles will pick you up right from your hotel and take you to one of their closest locations in Hamilton, Paget, St. George's, or Dockyard. Oleander Cycles will help you choose the best bike for your needs and give you a full demonstration on how to operate the scooter safely. And after your short lesson, you'll be on your own, free to explore our 400 miles of beautiful roads.
You're watching the Bermuda Channel.
What's one of the most prestigious locations in Bermuda? Harbour Road has always drawn the discerning few. Mansions along this magical waterfront are valued at upwards of $5 million. But so desirable is this location, seldom do homes become available. Until now, that is. Newstead Belmont Hills Golf Resort and Spa offers you something very rare: the opportunity to own a second home in Bermuda on this beautiful waterfront property at a fraction of the price it might normally cost and without the burden of year-round maintenance.
We feel the opportunity to own a luxurious waterfront home that is centrally located in Bermuda with all the amenities and services of a four-star resort is truly remarkable. For a limited time, we're offering deeded fractional ownership of one and two bedroom suites with prices starting at $99,000. The purchase is a real estate transaction, which means it can be sold or will. And as an owner, you'll receive 8 weeks residency here in Bermuda.
In addition to one of Bermuda's best locations, owners at Newstead Belmont Hills Golf Resort and Spa will enjoy all the amenities you would expect in a luxury resort of this caliber. A challenging 18-hole golf course, a world-class spa, a private water taxi, an infinity swimming pool, two restaurants, access to Bermuda's beaches.
It's got a great golf course I love to play on. It's got a great harbor view, and it's really affordable. The first time we saw the project, we bought immediately.
There's a great pool for the kids to play in, and a great spa and yoga for my wife.
Owners at Newstead will also be full members of Belmont Hills Golf Club, a semi-private resort course that offers some of the finest holes on the island. Belmont Hills resident golf professionals provide preferential personalized service to Newstead fractional homeowners. Only a few luxurious residences are still available after strong demand from vacationers looking to enjoy the fabulous lifestyle at Newstead Belmont Hills. We suggest you contact us soon to secure your island home.
Here we are, another beautiful evening in Bermuda at the Newstead Resort, centrally located with every possible amenity and a wonderful place to relax.
Newstead Belmont Hills is the perfect resort from which to enjoy the America's Cup experience, with World Series racing taking place right in front of the property. Contact us today for more information.
two-thirds of our Earth is covered in water, yet we understand more about the moon's surface than the deep oceans. The Bermuda Underwater Exploration Institute, BUEI, is an exciting, amazing, and educational experience where you can learn all about the wonders beneath the surface.
Bermuda itself is really interesting because it's a seamount that rises 12,000 feet from the ocean floor, and on top of it there's about 250 square miles of coral reef, and the island itself explains, you know, why we have so many shipwrecks. There's so much coral reef there and it drops down into so much water, and so Beebe and Barton, two pioneers of ocean exploration, came to Bermuda and dropped this bathysphere, this big steel ball, off the side of Bermuda's seamount into about 3,000 feet of water in the 1930s, and they saw all of these amazing creatures that no one had ever seen before, and some of the creatures that Beebe and Barton saw on their dives still haven't been seen since. It's such a mystery down in the deep ocean.
You too can take a dive 12,000 feet to the bottom of the ocean, just like Beebe and Barton in a virtual submersible at the BUEI. Dare to experience a simulated shark cage. Or learn about the invasion of lionfish and the threat that this alien species poses to the Atlantic Ocean's marine ecosystem.
We've got hundreds and hundreds of shipwrecks in Bermuda, and Bermuda really is the shipwreck capital of the world. Teddy Tucker, a marine archaeologist here, has done so much excavation. We're so lucky to have the artifacts that we do at BUEI.
There are many rare artifacts on display in the Teddy Tucker Shipwreck Gallery, including the mysterious Tucker Cross.
Jack Lightbourne has his shell collection here. It is the most phenomenal room. It's so beautiful. There's over 2,000 shells in there. It takes you to a place of just the utmost tranquility when you walk in. And that's the beauty of BUEI, is that it brings all of these unknowns to light, and we get to see them and learn so much amazing stuff.
Just open at the BUEI is an exciting new exhibit, Living with the Ocean, an interactive experience exploring the problems facing the world's oceans and a demonstration of some solutions. Thanks to Google Earth Liquid Galaxy screens, you can dive beneath the ocean to see the state of the world's coral reef system. The award-winning Harborfront Restaurant is conveniently located at BUEI. Two spacious boardrooms and a 148-seat auditorium at BUEI are designed to accommodate off-site meetings, presentations, and workshops. The BUEI is consistently voted one of Hamilton's top attractions on TripAdvisor. It's a must-see and a great learning experience for the whole family. The Bermuda Underwater Exploration Institute is just a short walk along East Broadway from Front Street in Hamilton and is open 7 days a week.
Port Royal is Bermuda's favorite golf course, offering superb golf for all. Port Royal hosts NCAA college tournaments, the NFL Bermuda Charity Golf Classic, the NCL Casinos at Sea Tournament, private golf club groups from the U.S. and Canada, the Pompano Ladies Pro-Am Golf Classic, prestigious local tournaments such as the Bermuda Open, and of course, Port Royal was the home of the PGA Grand Slam of Golf from 2009 to 2014, where the winners of the four majors, the Masters, the Open, the U.S. Open, and the PGA Championships play head-to-head. But Port Royal is not only for elite golfers. It was designed by the admired architect Robert Trent Jones to be interesting and fun for all, with immaculate greens and perfect fairways. The views are unlike you'll see at any other golf course, with each hole like a signature hole. The 16th may be the most photographed golf hole in the world. It is a regular at the top of the polls and surveys listing the world's best public courses, and is often compared to Pebble Beach and Torrey Pines. As you would expect, it has a 5-star rating on golfadvisor.com.
This was one of my favorite rounds of golf ever.
If you're looking to play an awesome island course, this is the best.
My all-time favorite course, hands down.
Everyone gave us that personalized treatment that makes you want to come back.
Port Royal has an outstanding 19th hole where you can relax after your round and enjoy legendary Bermudian hospitality. Plus, there's a fully equipped pro shop and what may be the most beautiful driving range in the world. Port Royal is a welcoming public golf course that both casual and serious golfers will enjoy. Groups and outside tournaments and events are also welcomed. Port Royal Golf Course. Superb golf for all. Visit Port Royal online or call 441-234-GOLF to book a tee time.
Bermuda's International Airport is a paradise for tax-free and duty-free shopping. And with three duty-free shops, it couldn't be easier for travelers to enjoy big savings. Welcome to Bermuda Duty Free's brand new shop located in the U.S. Departure Lounge. All the top fragrances in the world are here, as well as the major cigarette brands. And there's a dazzling selection of the world's finest spirits, including Bermuda's legendary Gosling's Black Seal Rum. All at savings of up to 50%. In fact, the prices here are lower than at most duty-free shops around the world. There's also a wonderful selection of gift ideas, including America's Cup polo shirts, t-shirts, hats, and bags. And eye-catching fashion jewelry at very popular prices. If you want to take some Bermuda-themed gifts back home with you, we've got a wonderful selection of those too, including our own unique Black Seal branded merchandise. There's even a Black Seal rum cake. Need headphones or power adapters for your trip? You'll find those in duty-free as well. If you're returning to Canada or the UK, there's a separate duty-free shop in the International Departure Lounge, featuring many of the same products, all at the same great savings. Here's a reminder for passengers who will be transiting through another airport. In some locations, you cannot take the duty-free liquids you purchased with you if your journey requires you to leave and re-enter a security-restricted area. One final tip. Next time you fly back to Bermuda, don't forget to stop by our arrivals duty-free shop located in the baggage hall. So when you arrive or depart the island, the best savings of your entire trip will be at Bermuda Airport's three duty-free shops.
Mini golf isn't what it used to be. Come and enjoy a round at Bermuda Fun Golf, the world's finest mini golf course. Situated on more than 1 acre of magnificent oceanfront, Fun Golf features 18 challenging and exciting holes modeled after the most famous golf holes in Bermuda, America, and Scotland. Play the 17th road hole from St. Andrews, the Island Green from TPC Sawgrass in Florida, the 12th hole across Rays Creek at Augusta, the short par 3 at Pebble Beach, and many other spectacular holes recognizable to even casual golf fans. You'll also enjoy the wonderful waterfall that flows into ponds, spectacular 180-degree views out over the ocean, and stunning sunsets. Fun Golf is also open for night play. After your round, relax in style, enjoying a drink at our Caddy Shack bar. The prices are the best on the island. Fun Golf is located in the Royal Naval Dockyard and is open 10 a.m. to 10 p.m.
Have you explored Washington Mall lately? Bermuda's only indoor shopping mall just keeps getting better with more shops, more services, and more fantastic dining options, all under one roof. Come see for yourself. From home furnishings to electronics to fashion for the whole family, the shops at Washington Mall are bound to have exactly what you're looking for. Experience the best in quality products and unparalleled personal service from local shop owners, all in fully air-conditioned comfort. Updated and upgraded to maximize your shopping enjoyment. Washington Mall hosts more than 50 retailers and service providers. Including fine restaurants designed to appeal to every palate. And an exciting new food court. centrally located in the heart of Hamilton, Washington Mall is the heart of Hamilton. So, shop in style, shop in comfort, and shop in the one place that has everything you need. Join us for a great shopping experience at Washington Mall.
Meet and be inspired by one of the ocean's most charismatic inhabitants, the dolphin. At Dolphin Quest, you'll enjoy swimming and interacting with dolphins in an enriching and fun experience that engages the mind, inspires the heart, and creates a powerful connection to our oceans. Dolphin Quest's expert animal behaviorists will guide you on an unparalleled journey of dolphin discovery. See firsthand how Dolphin Quest cares for these incredible marine animals and learn what you can do to protect dolphins in the wild. Hands-on, interactive programs are available for all ages, and program options include deep water, shallow water, and dockside experiences. Most of the dolphins you'll see were born right here, and if you're lucky, you might just see a baby. Your Dolphin Quest participation also supports critical marine conservation, education, and research. To date, Dolphin Quest has been honored to contribute over $3 million in funding, resources, and field support to vital marine research projects around the globe. Dolphin Quest is a featured attraction of the historic National Museum of Bermuda, which is located in the Royal Naval Dockyard, just walking distance from the ferry and cruise ship terminals, and amidst an eclectic array of boutiques, restaurants, and points of interest. To reserve your Dolphin Quest program, visit dolphinquest.com or call 441-234-4464.
You're watching the Bermuda Channel.